Remember how in operational planning, we want to know where we are now, or the current state of the operational environment, and then the commander describes what he or she wants the operational environment to look like when we complete the mission? That's the end state. And now there are several factors to consider when determining what it will take to achieve that end state. The commander and staff identify those several factors and tie them to a current or future decision that must be made. These are called decisive points. Decisive points are used to attack an enemy's center of gravity or protect our center of gravity from them. This is a common characteristic of a decisive point. In the context of the enemy, a decisive point's importance requires the enemy to commit significant resources to defend it, and the loss of a decisive point weakens their center of gravity and gets your foot in the door to expose more decisive points. A very important thing to remember, generally, there are more decisive points in an operational area than there are available forces and capabilities. So what does that mean? That means planners analyze and prioritize decisive points and figure out which one we should focus on and in what order to get us to the commander's end state. Our decisive points that have been identified for action now become objectives. And objectives can be physical, like destroy this force or seize this key terrain, or they can be conceptual, like establish the rule of law. The most important objective forms the basis for developing the decisive operation. And then you tie that most important objective and supporting objectives to the end state. So now you have your lines of operation or your lines of effort. For more on the elements of operational art, check out ADP 3.0 and ADP 5.0. And it'll also help to have in your kit bag ATP 5-0.1, Army Design Methodology. And you can get all these from the Army Publishing Directorate website at armypubs.army.mil.